We are entering the AI era. There's no escape from that, but we can do our best to benefit from the new tools at our disposal and not fall behind. I want to show you some super cool AI tools that I found that can help you boost your productivity and with your day-to-day tasks. From writing emails, managing tasks, to creating new assets for your endeavors and ideas. I selected a few tools worth mentioning, so let's dive in. Starting with Pictory AI. Pictory AI is a tool that can create videos from a script. It analyzes the text and uses keywords to determine what's the topic. From there, it adds short videos or short images related to the topic, add captions. You can change all of that if you don't like it. And it also has the option to add voiceover, so it reads your text and creates the video for you.
Butterflies are one of the most beautiful and intriguing creatures that we can find in nature.
But that's not all. The tool can also edit a video, an uploaded video from you, and add an intro, add an ending scene, add captions, generate tags, and even create shorter videos or highlights automatically from this video you uploaded. Now, DALL-E 2. I recently uploaded a short video about DALL-E, where you can see pretty much in a snapshot what it can do. This art generation tool is also from OpenAI, the same company that launched ChatGPT not long ago, 2 months, 3 months ago. You can create art just with the text prompting and get some fascinating results. What I like the most about this tool is that you can change the images that you get, so you can expand them, make them bigger, or you can remove and change little pieces of your image and generate new things for it. And you can even work on top of an image that you upload yourself. With a little prompting practicing, you can get very good results. Now, the Midjourney. Midjourney is by far the most impressive art generation AI tool that I have experimented with. You can use Midjourney in Discord and just write your prompts like messages to a bot and just get your results in a few moments. Midjourney promotes an open space for AI art, so everything you do and everything everyone does is open and everyone can see it. With that, all art that is generated with Midjourney can be found in the community gallery. And it's easy to lose track of time once you get in the gallery. Speaking from experience, along with everyone's art, you can also see the prompt that they use to get to that result. The AI also accepts parameters, for example, to change aspect ratio or styles. And one parameter in special that I like a lot is chaos. If you increase the chaos of your picture, you increase the randomness, and you can get pretty crazy results. The only downside that I see at the moment is that even the upscaled images, they have pretty low resolution. But Midjourney creates, for sure, the most beautiful images I have ever seen from an AI. You can even get logos and web pages, ideas, literally anything. You can also upload your own images to condition the AI to the certain style that you want to follow. But yeah, as I said, got the best results from anywhere else and I couldn't resist but get a subscription. But I would still recommend anyone to play around with the free images you can generate. MagicEraser is a tool to quickly and easily remove any unwanted object from your pictures. I honestly don't know what else I have to say about this. That's basically it. You upload your image, you select what you don't want in it, and it removes for you. Easy peasy. Next, AutoDraw. Another one I have a short about. AutoDraw is an experimental AI tool from Google that tries to identify what you're trying to sketch and suggests you some objects that could match that drawing and immediately makes it beautiful for you. It's really fascinating how easy it is to create a diamond out of a few lines that you put in the paper. You can also download and share your creations, and it's an easy way to create a simple asset that you need to share with someone, to explain something for someone, or just for fun, why not? For music, I found AIVA one of the best ones. I have played around with a couple of them, but they either sounded too robotic or they would generate just random stuff. AIVA is a music composition tool that allows you to create music according to your preferences. If you have some music theory knowledge, you're gonna do well with this one. You can select one of the audio tracks and modify the key to end up with fascinating results. Unfortunately, the free plan only allows 3 downloads a month, but if you're just like trying to experiment and if you need just like a soundtrack for a content or something like that, it might be enough. But if you really enjoy it, just feel free to go pro. I still think that it can be pretty useful if you're just creating something, a video, a presentation, and you need a soundtrack that is free licensing. It's your own creation. The license is yours. Notion is a special one. If you are an absolute crazy about productivity, just as I am, you probably already know this one. Notion is a planner and organizer with thousands of features that allows you to work with more people. It's different from the Atlassian tools because it's all in one. You can organize tasks, assign them to specific people, set due dates, write documentation, create a directory for people with pictures and contact information, for example, keep a journal, create task lists for your day-to-day activities, see a history of changes in any of those items, and so much more. I use Notion every day, the whole day. I always have it open. For example, in my Notion's calendar, I can see when I publish my videos, can keep track of my plans and ideas, write my scripts and document my research, and set the video status. From research to scripting to recording to editing to published. Notion has a ton of different templates that I'm certain that you're gonna find something that fits your needs. Furthermore, AI capabilities are coming to Notion. They are gonna help you to write faster, write better, with knowledge base, manage your schedule. It's not there yet, but you can put your name in the waiting list once you sign up for the service. You literally can keep track of your life in this tool. And of course, if you're not home, you're not in front of your computer, you can just install the app in your mobile phone and take it wherever you go. I'm still surprised that this powerful tool is free to use. Of course, there are some limitations for the free tier, as any other tool. But even the free plan offers so much, you cannot miss it. Now we have TLDRThis. If you're short on time and need to catch up with some reading, this tool is for you. Just paste the link to the article that you want to read or to the page, or just copy paste the text itself, and this tool is going to summarize everything for you. You can even choose between a very concise summary or a more detailed one that separates the content by chapters. If you are a ChatGPT fan, you're gonna love this one. Did you know that you can use ChatGPT directly from your browser? I mean, you don't have to go to the webpage and you don't have to open your terminal either. You can just install this extension and you can use ChatGPT anytime you want. But in my opinion, the best part is that when you Google something, you get a summary from, like an answer from ChatGPT directly on Google. And you can see what ChatGPT would say about that just right there, right next to the search results. Now, I have looked through several tools to write faster and better, and all of them have pros and cons. But let's go through some of them and you can decide for yourself which one you like the most. Let's start with the Compose AI. This is a Chrome extension that helps you to write faster by suggesting words and sentences for auto-completion or just for you to have new ideas, or create full text for you. Once you install the extension, you're gonna see a small blue dot full of drop shadow around it in every single input field that you can write in. If you click this blue dot, you're gonna see a few options, including the compose option. And there it works more or less like ChatGPT. You just write in the prompt what you need to write. For example, write me a joke, and it's gonna write a joke for you. This can be pretty useful when you're writing emails and it's gonna write the email for you, you just send it. However, I find the texts that it can write kinda short, very simple, and I feel like there's a little bit of creativity missing, the creativity we found in ChatGPT, and that just made us fall in love with ChatGPT, you know what I mean? But yeah, at least you can go wild and make some jokes, write a prank with no big issues. Something now you cannot do with ChatGPT anymore. Let's see what I mean. The ChatGPT writer works kind of similar to the Composer AI. You can also just use prompting to describe what you need them to write for you. However, since the heavy moderation was implemented in ChatGPT in the past weeks, it's kind of boring. So ChatGPT is awesome if you're highly professional, you cannot joke with it. It's boring. I feel like ChatGPT now is more like a grumpy Merlin. you know, old and wise, but also boring and strict and serious. But yeah, another extension that I use quite a lot is the HyperWriter. HyperWriter helps me out by completing my sentences or give me other ideas about what I could write there, and I really enjoy it, to be honest. Of course, as any other tool, it also offers some limitations for the free tier, but is already a big help. Now, as someone who doesn't speak English as my first language, this one is pretty good and essential for me. The grammar and spell checker Chrome extension does all the heavy lifting when I'm writing. It automatically tells me, hey, this is wrong. It does just underlines the mistake that I did and suggests me ways to fix it. I find it interesting when it finds errors in text that comes from ChatGPT. Well, it's basically it. It corrects your mistakes, not automatically. You have to say if you want to accept the correction or if you want to ignore it, whatever you want. Sometimes the mistake is intentional, but it saves a lot of time. But yeah, it's very useful and makes you look like a native English speaker. I mean, writer. Now, you know when you have that sentence in your head? Like, where the hell did I hear this from? And you keep trying to remember where you heard it before, but you can't. Now you don't have to waste any more time trying to figure out where you heard that. Now there's a tool for that. And that's Yarn. In Yarn, you can simply type whatever the quote is that you are thinking so much about that you heard somewhere before. Just type the quote there and it's gonna show you every single series, movies, animations where that quote was used. And once you find the origin of this quote that wouldn't leave your mind, you can download the scene as a video or a GIF and even create a meme out of it. So yeah, Yarn is just a lot of fun. And I want to finish with a more technical one, JEDBio. JEDBio stands for Just Another Data Biologist and is a web-based platform that provides automated machine learning solutions. Even though it was mainly created for biological purposes to analyze biological data and experiments, it can actually be used for anything, any type of data. It's very cool for anyone interested in Python and getting into machine learning. Their documentation is excellent. They have video tutorials, they have examples, little projects that you can go with. And yeah, all you need is data and then you can get your hands dirty and start analyzing your data. It's very cool that you can already get some principles of how machine learning works without the heavy coding that you can focus on afterwards. So if you are a machine learning enthusiast, I can really recommend to play around with this one. The free plan already covers the basic operations that you need to get started with machine learning, so you don't have to worry about that. But that's all I have for you guys today. I hope you liked it. I hope you go ahead and try some of those tools. Let me know in the comments if you tried any of those tools, if you like them, and just give me your feedback. I'm happy to hear. And I see you guys in the next one. Bye!